in chemical composition. For example, so any difference is that in that living organism and a non-living organism in chemical composition. For example, you take that earth crust of piece. Then you observe that, okay, and you make, you do chemical analysis, or you make chemical analysis in earth crust. Chemical analysis. In earth crust. Okay, same type of chemical composition is present in that, okay, living organism and also in the earth crust. So, in living organism, chemical composition, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, okay, same chemical composition. But in the earth crust having that same chemical composition. Same chemical composition. But what is the difference between that, okay, living material and non-living material? So what are the same living composition? Carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen. But what is that main difference between that chemical composition of living organism and non-living organism? It means carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen ratio is more in living organism than that earth crust. Than the earth crust. Okay, same having the carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. So this non-living organisms also same chemical composition, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. But what is the major difference? So carbon, hydrogen, oxygen ratio is more in, okay, living organisms than that non-living organism or earth crust. Mostly, so oxygen percent is more in living organisms than that earth crust, and related to that other ratio is also, okay, more in that living organism than that non-living organism. So that is the difference between that chemical composition of living organism and non-living organism.